Hello, I'm Graham and welcome to this video in which I'll be taking a closer look at Panasonic's latest travel zoom camera, the TZ70, or the ZS50 as it's known, in North America. I decided to purchase this camera for three reasons. Firstly, it bucks the industry trend of ever increasing the pixel count on these tiny 1/2-inch sensor cameras. Panasonic have reverted back to a 12.8 megapixel sensor, which translates to an effective pixel count of 12.1 megapixels. Of course, it's not new. We've had 12.1 megapixel sensors in previous Panasonic compact cameras and indeed in the FZ200 bridge camera. But let's hope the latest improvement in BSI technology and micro lenses adds to the image quality of the camera. For me personally, if the lens and sensor combined with the image processing pipeline have all been optimised, I'm sure the results will be much improved over the previous models. Going back to a 12.1 megapixel camera is a big gamble for Panasonic when the rest of the industry is increasing the number of pixels on their sensor. In a like-for-like shooting environment in average daylight, both the 12.1 megapixel TZ70 and the 18 or 21 megapixel cameras from Sony and Canon will operate at base ISOs of around about 100 and will perform equally well. At this low ISO, noise isn't generally considered a problem. And in these circumstances, the Sony and Canon cameras might actually have more image detail, providing the lens has sufficient contrast and resolution needed to take advantage of the higher pixel density. However, for the average user, displaying images on a PC screen or sharing them on a social media site, the difference will probably go unnoticed. Secondly, the EVF, or electronic viewfinder, has been upgraded to 1.2 megapixels in this camera, overall giving a better viewing experience. It's still only a 0.2 peephole, but in bright sunshine, something you hope to experience with a holiday travel camera, it's invaluable, as viewing on an LCD screen, as we know, is almost impossible in bright sun. And thirdly, the camera now supports a basic time-lapse video shooting mode. The settings are a little restrictive, but a welcome addition to your creative tool library. To give you some idea of the camera's performance, I've put together a short showcase of stills and video clips. Shot in as wide a subject type as possible and a variety of lighting setups from bright sun to very low museum lighting levels. I've also included a couple of time-lapse videos shot at 10-second intervals and then rendered in the camera as a 5 frame per second and 25 frame per second video clip. In my next video, I'll present a mega test of this camera with the previous versions like the TZ20, the TZ30, the TZ40 travel zooms, and the FZ200 and the FZ1000 bridge camera. The tests have been shot under studio control conditions, and you'll be able to establish for yourselves whether the Panasonic's gamble has paid off and whether this camera is a worthwhile upgrade to the previous TZ60 model. So that's it for this short video. If you are a new viewer to this channel, please consider clicking that subscribe button. There will be more videos on the TZ70 to give you some more ideas of how this camera is performing. And also have a look at my photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below. You'll find more information and reviews of this TZ70 and other things like to FZ200 and FZ1000 topics. So until my next video, thanks again for watching. Please take care, and it's Graham saying bye for now.